warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة
Obey him, the messenger, you will be rightly guided.
And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has made the greatest sign of loving Him. The greatest sign to show that a person loves Allah is to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Say, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. I follow the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah will love you and He will forgive your sins. And He is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Ibad Allah, we need to understand that there is not any good aspect of our religion except that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed us about it. And there is not any evil that He has warned us about it. And among the things that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed us and He commanded us is to obey the rulers, to obey the leaders, those who have authority among us. As long as that ruler does not command us to disobey Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ati'u Allah wa ati'u al-rasul wa uli al-amri minkum. All you who believe, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and those of authority among you. This command of obeying the rulers and the leaders, it is not the command which comes from the ulama only. This is the command which is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. As Allah said in the Quran, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and those who have authority among you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions in the hadith which is from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عليك السمع والطاعة في عسرك ويسرك ومنشطك ومكرهك وأثرة عليك. رواه مسلم. It is obligatory for you to listen to the ruler and obey him. It is obligatory to listen to the ruler and obey him. في عسرك. When it is difficult for you, وَيُسْرِكَ, and when it is easy for you to do that, وَمَنْشَطِكَ, and when you like it, وَمَكْرَهِكَ, and when you dislike it, وَأَثَرَتِنَ عَلَيْكَ, and even if someone else has been given preference over you. And Rasulullah sallallahu also says, in another hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أطاعني فقد أطاع الله. Whoever obeys me, he has indeed obeyed Allah. ومن عصاني فقد عصى الله. And whoever disobeys me has disobeyed Allah. ومن أطاع أميري فقد أطاعني. And whoever obeys my ruler, he has obeyed me. ومن عصى أميري فقد عصاني. And whoever disobeys my ruler has disobeyed me. Rawahu al-Bukhari. Imam Muhammad, he mentioned in his book Al-Usul al-Sitta, six principles. And one of those principles, which is Al-Aslu al-Thalith, the third principle, he mentions about obeying the leaders and the rulers. He says, Anna min tamam al-ijtima' السمع والطاعة لمن تأمر علينا ولو كان عبدا حبشيا. Verily, from the completion of unity is hearing and obeying the one who has taken authority over us, even if it is be an Abyssinian slave. So he mentioned that if the Muslims want a proper unity and we want to be united as Muslims, then one of the things that will complete our unity is for us to obey those who have authority over us. فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ هَذَا بَيَانًا شَافِيًا كَافِيًا بِوُجُوهٍ مِّنْ أَنْوَاعِ الْبَيَانِ شَرْعًا وَقَدْرًا ثُمَّ صَارَ هَذَا الْأَصْلُ لَا يُعْرَفُ عِنْدَ أَكْثَرِ مَنْ يَدَّعِ الْعِلْمِ فَكَيْفَ الْعَمَلُ بِهِ. Then he says, so Allah Ta'ala has explained this with a clear, a broad and sufficient explanation by way of many aspects of numerous types of explanation, both in the Sharia and in terms of divine decree. Allah has mentioned this very clearly, and He has explained this very clearly, both in the Sharia and in divine decree. So then this foundation became unknown to many of those who claim knowledge. So how could it be acted upon? So the Sheikh says that this foundation became unknown to many people. And those who claim to have knowledge, you will see a person who claims to be upon the Sunnah, but if it his leader does not agree with what he wants, he will not obey. And this is not right. This is what the Sheikh says. The Sheikh says that many who claim to have knowledge, they don't know this foundation, so how can it be acted upon? If you don't know that this is a command from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and it is a command from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that it is upon a Muslim to obey the ruler, whether you like it or you don't like it, whether it is easy or it is difficult, even if someone else has been given preference over you, as long as that ruler does not command you to disobey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, then we have to obey him. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. I advise you and myself to fear Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Ibadallah, the only time we don't obey the ruler is when he commands us to disobey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. As it came in the hadith, which is narrated by Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال على المرء المسلم السمع والطاعة فيما أحب وكره إلا أن يؤمر بمعصية فإن أمر بمعصية فلا سمع ولا طاعة. رواه مسلم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, it is obligatory upon a Muslim that he should listen to the ruler appointed over him and obey him, whether he likes it or not, except that he is ordered to do a sinful act. If he is ordered to do a sinful act, then he should neither listen and nor obey. And the rulers will include those who have authority and the leaders of the countries as well. So obeying the rulers is not only the Muslims' one. Even those who are not Muslims, as long as they don't command to disobey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, if they have authority upon us, then it is a must, it is obligatory for us to obey them. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار أقول ما تسمعون والله أعلم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah. Amen.
So, Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمن وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانن كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم ولا تحاضون على طعام المسكين وتأكلون التراث أكلا لما وتحبون المال حبا جما كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا وجيء يومئذ بجهنم يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره.
الله أكبر. الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله